So it's conceptual as opposed to visual. In other words, the concept of red mm-hmm. is something that my brain knows.
Yes.
But the word is not red, the word is black.
Exactly, exactly.
No wonder my poor brain is confused. Russell Mills, and I'm here with Dr. Dolores Vasquez, and you're with the OSU Health Sciences?
Yes, that's correct.
And she is an expert in brains, which is something that kind of interests me, and we've even chopped up some brains and put them in plastic to talk about. But tell me first off, what got you interested in neurology and studying the brain as opposed to all the other branches of science?
Well, it's kind of funny because I was terrible when I was a kid. I was terrible at science. But suddenly I have a professor that actually took me under his wing and showed me how the neurons look under the microscope. And it was just so fascinating seeing that moment, that neuron right there. So I think it's my passion just became in that moment. So.
And the brain is a super complicated machine that does all this stuff, and we're just starting to understand.
We don't know much about it. We don't use it very much, and it's quite interesting how the brain actually controls probably your whole body. So without a brain, you are not a human. So brain is what makes you human.
Right, so there's that term brain dead. So when the brain's not working, they pretty much turn off the lights.
Yeah, okay. That's right.
So you brought a couple of show and tell items for us today.
Yeah, sure.
Thanks for doing that.
Yes.
Why don't we talk about this first?
So what I wanted to show you guys is how sometimes our brain can trick us a little bit. So what I'm gonna go ahead and do is I'm gonna make Russell say the color of each word. But as you see here, we read black, right? But the color is red. So let's go and challenge Russell and see how he goes.
Okay, so my job is to say the color, not the word.
Exactly.
All right, let's see if I can do this. All right, so I'll kind of hold it that way. No, you're fine.
Okay.
So, see, red, black, green, blue, yellow, red. It's harder than you might think. Blue, yellow, black, red, green, black, blue, green, blue, red, black. Okay, why am I having to stop and think about it?
Okay, so this is a really great question. So this is a really simple test that you guys can use for actually show how the brain works based on visual cues. So it's really, really interesting that our brain wants to pay attention to everything that our eyes is telling it that is there. So because your visual cue is telling you this is red, but wait a second, is the word is read as black. So you actually have to force your brain to pay attention to the color and not the word.
So it's conceptual as opposed to visual. In other words, the concept of red mm-hmm. is something that my brain knows.
Yes.
But the word is not red, the word is black.
Exactly, exactly.
No wonder my poor brain is confused.
Yeah, but this is super cool. So this is something that you can just download it from any website, and you can challenge your students or your mom or your cousins at home. And then what you can do is actually explain them what part of the brain is the one that is responsible. So we have two main parts on the brain. So you will have your frontal lobe right here.
Which is?
Right there, exactly. So this one is super, super important because the frontal lobe is the part of your brain that is gonna help you to make decisions. Everything, since what are you gonna wear today, as about what you are gonna say. Like, for example, in the test that we just did a moment ago. And then.
So it was my frontal lobe that was saying, no, no, ignore the color, the word is, or ignore the word, the color is.
Exactly.
So all that's going on up here.
Exactly.
Okay.
But then you have another two brain areas that are super, super interesting, which is called Broca's area and Wernicke's area. So Broca's and Wernicke are going to be those great brain areas that are gonna allow you to actually not only understand, but also produce language. So, do you know Spanish by any chance?
Un poquito.
Un poquito. So if I tell you right now, ferrocarril, what does that mean?
Ferrocarril?
Yes.
Something about fire?
No, it's actually a train. So
a
because
train.
Yeah, so your Wernicke area has not been exposed to Spanish, so it's the reason why you don't know the meaning of that. So just for this simple test, you require your frontal lobe and your language areas as Broca and Wernicke.
Okay, we've got one more to show real
yes.
quick.
So this is another view of the brain. So this one is, we were chopping our brain right here. So this one is more like in this plan right here, okay? So here we have those areas that are so important for language.
Okay, right here in the middle?
Mm-hmm. And then in the upper part, we will have all that prefrontal cortex that is helping us to make decisions and actually kind of fight to say the word and not the color.
Okay, well, we are out of time, but I'll tell you, I could talk to you for an hour. So thank you very much.
Yeah,
Dr.
my
Dolores
pleasure.
Vasquez. I'm Russell Mills.